got a song this morning?
What's that,
293?
93.
93. Page 93 in the same book.
Everybody help us in the choir, y'all come on. And let's get in the blue book or brown book. The brown one has words.
Excuse me, guys.
Let's start off with page 75.
Thank you.
city. B flat? B flat?
Bye. Let us all stand. You feel the need to come and pray, you come and pray. Why don't you sing a song?
Anybody. You just want to talk to the Lord this morning. He said, my house should be called the house of prayer. Might it always be in him.
Thank you.
bless her heart. Amen. This is what you do when you come to church. You worship. And you talk to the one who knows the very thoughts and intents of your heart. And he'll help you. He really will. I appreciate everybody following the Lord and doing that. You feel like you need to do in your heart. I really do. I want to give a flower out for all those that's helping and all the for the video service. I was talking to Lucy Stowers last night. And she was talking and telling me what a blessing that is to her. Now, we that know Lucy always came so faithfully while she could, but now she's down towards Atlanta where Wayne's helping take care of her, and she can't make that journey. And I was telling, I know there's others, talk to Cindy and Shane, and there's others that can't come right now. I know Sweet Deborah would love to be here. And there's many. So I want to give a flower out for that ministry. I'll tell you what. But you that can come, aren't you glad that you got strength and health in your body? I tell you, if you haven't thanked the Lord for your health lately, how about thanking him? I'm telling you that we need to do. The Lord knows the very heart, what's on our hearts to do. So we want you all to be faithful and do that the Lord leads you to do. And we got another song we're going to sing? Oh, okay. We'll do that. We want everybody to stand for a moment. And let's turn around and look at everybody. You don't have to shake nobody's hand. But let them know you're glad they're in the house of the Lord.
There lays a crown that fell. Dried on the thorns. There are the sandals they took from his feet. See how they're dusty and worn. There stands
someone.
just realize I'm the one. I'm the one. He shed his life's blood to save, and I'm the reason he rose from the grave. I'm the reason for those worn out sandals. You see, he walked every mile just for me.
Hey, we appreciate that. I hope that you know that. I hope you know he did everything just for you. And if you don't, oh, what a wonderful day for you to come find the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior. And we appreciate each and every one coming this morning and want you to pray. I asked Brother Jamie to come and bring the message. He got to tugging on my heart last week, and I called him up, and I appreciate Jamie and Alicia and all the family, how faithful they've been. And I had the privilege to talk to Jamie a little bit a few weeks back, and he was telling me about some things that happened in his life, a very serious accident. I believe he was somewhere around 18, 19 years old, and almost took him home. But he did. You know, I believe there's a purpose and there's a time for you and I in this life. The Bible plainly says it's time to be born, time to die. And I believe it's set if you and I don't mess it up. And my friends, and I want you to know, the Lord wants you to live life to the fullest. Somebody says, I want to die for him. Listen, he's done died for us all. He wants you to live for him. Amen. He wants you to live every day that you have and live it to the fullest and be proud of it. And Brother Jamie is sharing that, and the Lord led him to what he's doing today. And the Lord called him into ministry, and he's even a chaplain there at the firehouse. He works it and all, and a help to those. So I want you to pray for him. I really do. And all. And if you're here and you don't know the Lord. Now, friend, I'm telling you, we're living a lot of times where a lot of people have joined the church. Somebody told them to. They got baptized. They went through the pretense of it. I'm telling you, there's no membership as good as Yellow Creek or any other church going to get you to heaven. My father gave his son the book, and he's holding the book. And if he wrote your name in it, you'll go in. But if he didn't, he will not say, well, it was okay. You was a good person. He'll say, depart. I did not know you. So if you're not saved this morning, I mean, you don't have that assurance in your heart. I pray you listen to the word as Brother Jamie comes. And if you're his child, and maybe we can even get to a place where we forgot we've ever been purged from our old sins. The Bible says that. Maybe you need to go back to a Bethel and check up in your heart. But make sure that you've got that before it's too late. And we ask that you would pray for him now. Heavenly Father, we thank you for everybody who's come, and we thank you for the wonderful spirit through the. We enjoyed Sunday school so much, and even the singing, Lord, how it blessed our hearts, and we thank you for all those that. Now, Lord, we pray that you take the messengers about to stand, and Lord, the spirit would flow, and we pray that he'll say that only you give him. And I pray, Father, if there's one lost, they would come today. If there's somebody drifted away, they'd come back home. And we're going to give you all the glory, for it's in Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen. Come on.
Good morning.
Good morning.
This morning, if y'all want to turn with me, we're going to be in the book of Acts, and we're going to be in the 16th chapter. As y'all were flipping there, there has been some scripture that had been on my heart that I thought the Lord would lead us to preach at this morning. But on the way here, it seemed that things had turned. And as I pulled into the parking lot, the scripture came to my mind that it's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of an almighty God. This is definitely not my place of comfort. This isn't where I'd much rather be. There's many places I'd much rather be at this morning than behind the pulpit. But we use that scripture a lot of times to refer to preaching or to salvation, but it falls even into the hands of the singers this morning and the specials, as the Holy Spirit that we've already felt this morning. Had they not been in God's will, we wouldn't have been able to feel the Spirit this morning that we've already felt. And I'd just like to thank y'all for that. We're going to begin in Acts chapter 16 and verse 23, and it says, "And when they had laid many stripes upon them, they cast them into the prison, charging the jailer to keep them safely, who, having received such a charge, thrust them into the inner prison and made their feet fast into the stocks. And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundation of the prisons were shaken, and immediately all the doors were open and everyone's bonds were loosened. And the keeper of the prison, awakened out of his sleep and seeing the prison doors open, he drew out his sword and would have killed himself, supposing that the prisoners had been fled. But Paul cried with a loud voice, saying, Do not harm thyself, for we are all here. And then he called for a light, and he sprang in and came trembling and fell down before Paul and Silas and brought them out and said, Sirs, what must I do to be saved? And they said, Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, that thou shalt be saved and thy house. If you would, Jared, bless the reading.
The great spirit, God, we can feel so far, Lord, and getting over into the preaching hour, God, I pray this morning, Lord, that you just come by, Lord. We know, God, from experience that you'll be there, God, for Brother Jamie this morning as he tries to make that across to God, that we can't get to ourselves, God, for sure we couldn't do with ourselves, Lord, but I pray this morning that your hand come by all to his, Lord, this morning as he makes the crossing here, Lord, that's behind the sacred desk this morning, Lord, and as I pray, God, that your spirit just pour out on this place, Lord, and Lord, you can seek and search, God, the hearts and the souls of men and women, boys and girls this morning, that neither me or him or Ricky or nobody, Lord, this morning can see, and I pray, Lord, that somebody needs to find you, God, this morning, precious to their never-dying soul, Lord, that they realize the situation, God, that they're in, and they realize, Lord, that they're being told, they're being preached to and sung to, Lord, this morning, way out of all that, Lord, this morning, that's coming and being saved, God, is the word we just read, God. I pray you blessing on the rest of this service, God, that your hand be in it, Lord. I thank you for this day and all of our blessings, God, most of all, this morning, our salvation. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jared. It seems that we live in a world today where decisions have a costly price. We were talking in just general conversation the other day at the fire department of weighing out public school and private school and Christian school and weighing out the things and the decisions that we have to make as parents for our children, what would be the best option of what we thought and our opinions. Each one of those come with a great risk. Each one of those come with a great risk. Each one of those, of whether we show up to church this morning, whether we decide to bring our children to Vacation Bible School, whether we decide to go on the youth trip that we're leaving on here next weekend, each one of those decisions come with a cost at the end of it. My greatest fear ever since I announced my calling to preach is that I would be a stumbling block, or that I'd be a hindrance, that I wouldn't be in the place that I need to be at to preach in, and that I may cause somebody else to stumble, or so cause somebody else to fall, cause somebody maybe that had the key to the service not to move, or maybe that one that was under conviction not to come down and to be saved. And we find that story here with many different members inside, and it's not a story, it's an account of actually what has taken place in Paul and Silas's life, and that's something that we've got to get back to, is when we read the Word of God, this isn't a fictional story. When we read even downstairs in the nursery, when you're reading the Daniels in the Lion's Den, and you're reading these children books, that's not a fictional story, Ricky. That took place. Daniel wound up in the Lion's Den. Paul and Silas were beat here. They weren't just, smacked on the tail end and threw down into a prison. No, they were beat. They said that they laid stripes upon them and cast them into the prison. That they put such a charge to the jailer to be able that they would stay inside that jail, that he put them in the innermost part of the prison. He fastened their feet. They were beat. They were shackled. They're inside the innermost part of the prison. The jailer says, hey, you know what? My job is good here. You know, my job is safe. I've done what they've told me to do. There's no way that these men are coming out. Paul and Silas are sitting there at midnight. Paul and Silas had a choice to make right here. They begin to pray out loud. They begin to sing praises, and they're in the innermost part of the prison, but that all the prisoners had heard them. This wasn't a quiet prayer. This wasn't just them sitting in the corner singing hymns to entertain one another. No, they were praising their Lord. They were praising their God. They were singing it with intention, just as the choir sang this morning, just as the specials and the ladies that got up and sang this morning. They were singing with intention. They were singing with intention to be heard. And singing praises to God, and the prisoners heard them. And it says, and suddenly there was a great earthquake. Of all the things that the jailer had prepared himself for, all the things that Paul and Silas had prepared themselves for that evening, the other jailers that were there, whether they were just merely sitting there enjoying the singing and praises or wishing that they were thinking of their day tomorrow, each one of them played a part, and none of them were expecting an earthquake. The Lord sent an earthquake. He sent an earthquake that was so strong that it should the foundation of the prison, that it shook them all the way to the core, that it shook them all the way to the innermost part of that prison, to the innermost foundation of that prison's being. And it said, and immediately all the doors were open. At this point, you got a prison. There is not a prison in this world today that if the doors begin to shake open, that somebody ain't trying to get out. They ain't there because they want to be. They're not there. This wasn't the Hall County Jail. They don't have TVs and vending machines. They were in a deep, dark, nasty prison, a place that anybody would have wanted to get out at. And it says that everyone's bonds were loosened. And the keeper of the prison, he pulls out. He was asleep. He thought that his job was done. He thought that, hey, man, I've covered all of my bases. I've done everything that I have to do. I'm going to sit back and wait till morning now. And that he looked down and he seen all the prison doors were open. The decision that he makes right here is a very quick and a swift one. That he decides in his mind that he weighs out of what the consequences were for him. And that he decides that it would be best for him just to kill himself than to allow of what the Romans would have done to him at that point. That if the Romans would have found out that all the prisoners were loose, that Paul and Silas said that he had not done his job, that it had been better off for him to kill himself. At the same time that this is happening, Paul and Silas again have a decision to make. This decision has to be within inside the will of the Lord for this jailer to be saved, as we have already read. It says, but Paul cried out loud with a loud voice and saying, do thyself no harm, for we are all here. For we are all here. If one of them had left, if one of them had made a decision of their own, if they had not answered to the conviction that they must have had, that had to be conviction. That had to be a conviction for them not to get up and leave, for a bunch of prisoners not to leave. But that they were all there. And that the jailer, he's going to do thyself no harm, for we're all here. He says, well, bring me a light. So they bring him a light, and he comes down, and it says that he came in trembling and fell down before Paul. For we know the Word of God says that salvation is found through fear and on trembling knees. For this is exactly the point that jailer was in. Maybe that's this morning. Maybe that's the exact point that you're in, that you've reached. No, you've tried everything that you can try, and that there's no end in sight. That you feel that you're at a dead end road this morning. That maybe you came to church out of out of schedule. This is something that you've always done. Maybe it was a last cry for help. Maybe that it was just a church that happened to be on the side of the road this morning that you decided to pull in, and conviction has come your way this morning. For each one of us has done our part. Each one of us has been into the will of God, and this morning when we're fixing to have an altar call, stand if y'all would come. For it says that that he came in the night, and they brought them out and said, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" And they said, "Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ with all thy heart, and thou shalt be saved." This morning, I don't come to cast judgment or to judge any other church this morning, but I am here to tell you that that's the only way that salvation works. That's the only way that you can be saved this morning. There's not a prayer. There's nowhere inside this Bible that you're going to find a written out statement that you have to make to be saved. There's nowhere in this Bible that says that there's a step-by-step plan of what you must do to be saved. There's no filling out of cards or anything else this morning. That it's just that it's that you've reached the final end of the road, and that your own fear and trembling knees, that you come this morning. For each one of us has their own testimony. My testimony is not like anybody else's, for it's mine. At 8 years old, we were at River Bend Baptist Church, and I remember Bucky standing up and preaching, thinking, man, he's never going to get done. He's never going to get done in time to hush and close the Word of God so that I can come and be saved this morning. And this is my testimony, and it's not anybody else's, but that morning that I took that step of faith, and I took that step out of the pew, and I began to walk down, nothing else mattered after that point. That's me. So that ain't everybody else's case, for there's many that's had to work that out down here at the altar, and that very well may be the case for you this morning. But you have to make that step of faith. There has to be conviction to be able to have that step of faith to come down this morning to be saved. Ricky.
Bless you, Lord. Let's sing.
Appreciate the wonderful message. And church, we got to pray. I'm telling you, good Lord's willing, the third Sunday we're going to start revival. But and there's so many good things that are happening around this church. But if you're not careful, you're going to get content. You're going to say it. But I'm telling you, some people need to get saved around this place. I don't know if you could be a grandma, grandpa, a mom and dad, a teenager, a child. I know not, but I know the Spirit of God. And the Lord sent a wonderful message to touch your heart that you might be saved. And we're going to continue to pray. We really are. I want everybody to continue to be thoughtful and have a heart. Brother Stan, sing one more verse. Just can't stop. Thank you. I promise you, I'll stop. One more verse. The Lord's asking somebody to come and be saved. I feel that. Will you come?
Hear you not the earnest plea of her friends that wish you well.
Turn to the Lord now.
As before tomorrow, you will be called to meet your God. There is sorrows, for he will mourning. For your lives will be long. Oh, how sad to face the judgment, unprepared to meet the black God.
Brother Brandon, will you lead us, Lord, in prayer? Heavenly Father knows the hearts of all the people.
If somebody might have something on your heart. I always say it, believe it. The Lord saved you even in your seat. The Bible said we believe in our heart unto righteousness, we profess with our mouth unto salvation. You'll never feel the full joy of the Lord until you tell it, my friend.
That's right,
Rick. Anybody? All hearts are clear. I'm glad I came today. I hope you feel the same. If not, I hope you come back. Really do. And we appreciate everybody coming. Appreciate your attention. And we're going to ask Briston to come down. He's going to give a prayer request. And we want to take all these prayer requests here, folks. We really do. And the Lord knows the sickness is going to be in our lives, and we don't even know. Why do you have your help to the Lord pray? And all. And listen to all these that don't have faith in their life. All right? And Chris, can you come back to me?
I will say Nancy Dill's watching this morning on Facebook. She said keep her and Edwin in your prayers. So let's remember that. Remember Chris Hoff, as we mentioned earlier. Are there any other prayer requests this morning?
Rita Satterfield.
Rita Satterfield. Remember Rita. Any others? Linda Strickland and Ruth Chester, remember them. Thank you, Terry. Yes, remember our military, all those that are serving. Peggy. Remember Peggy Kemp. Any others?
Christian, I'd ask the church to please pray for Jean. 6 o'clock in the morning, she goes and has a simple test ran. See if they can find out why she's so anemic. But I'd ask the church to just some time for now that time to pray.
Tomorrow morning,
remember? My heart's been so heavy this morning. Somebody has turned the side of it.
Yes, sir.
My heart don't feel this way. Somebody's got turned the side of love. Remember those, most of all.
Most of all, the ones that are lost, yes. Remember Gene Connor. Any others? Remember the youth trip this weekend, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Remember them, and then East Hall's revival starting tonight. Any others? Any unspoken prayer requests this morning? Let's remember all of those. The Lord knows the need in all those cases.
Gather that the Spirit leads them and stirs in their heart for somebody to be saved.